brought to you by Chevrolet. With the performance, the style, the innovation, the quality, and the value that make up today's Chevrolet. Levi Strauss & Company, official outfitter of the U.S. Olympic team and the 1984 Olympic Games. Kellogg's Corn Flakes. Those crispy, crunchy, golden flakes of corn are a wholesome and delicious way for everyone in your family to start their day. And General Electric. GE makes products that make life easier and better. At GE, we bring good things to life.
Here in the sports arena, third and final round action. Young Mo Heo of South Korea against Efren Tabanez of the Philippine Islands. This has been a good fight. The favored Korean facing a very decent tussle from the tough customer from the Philippines, Tabanez. It's been an excellent fight to watch from the point of view of discussing Olympic scoring, in my opinion. Harder blows have been leveled by Tabanez, but those blows have been much less frequent than the Koreans' constancy of scoring with the left jab, a caution to the South Korean. A little bit of wrestling. Saw the hand speed too. Now one hard blow that excites the fans, if scored by Tabanez, doesn't compare to the seven blows registered unanswerably in succession by the South Korean. Even there, that flicking left getting in there. All the while, Tabanez seeking to land one blow. This round clearly overwhelming. There it was, the left finally clawed Tabanez. It seemed almost inevitable. This South Korean will be a very tough customer for Steve McCrory because of the reach edge he will have on Steve. Tabanez tries to strike back. You hear the crowd getting into it. But I think this could be it. Let's see. Doctor looking. Nope. Doctor's going to permit him. Blood in the mouth. Doctor's going to permit him to continue. And so the fight resumes. We have 50 seconds left in the fight. Question as the South Korean continues to score almost at will. But in its way, a very interesting fight. These youngsters from the Philippine Islands are good fighters. I remember in 68 at the Mexico City Arena when the late Al Robinson was facing a Philippine fighter who had KO'd a prior opponent, and he was giving Robinson fits when suddenly Robinson caught him with the kind of left hook that Patterson landed against Johansson on June 20th, 1960, and poof, that was it for the Filipino. And this is about it for Tabanez. We'll be back with the decision, and it has to be, of course, for the South Korean, without question.